Hello, passengers. We now invite our platinum pioneers to board. Platinum pioneers may board at this time. Thank you.
Your seatbelt, please.
Passengers. At this time, the forward entry door is closed. All large electronic devices should now be shut off and stowed, and all small portable electronic devices must be set to airplane mode. Make sure your seat backs and tray tables are in their full upright and locked position, and that your seat belt is correctly fastened. Should you have any difficulty with this, please ring your call button and a flight attendant will guide you through the process. If you've not yet done so, please stow your carry-on luggage underneath the seat in front of you or in the overhead bin, taking care not to force any item into a space that is too small for it. Then please take your seat and fasten your seatbelt. If you are seated in an emergency exit row, carefully read the safety information card located in your seat back pocket. If you do not wish, are unable, or unwilling to perform the functions described in the event of an emergency, a flight attendant will reseat you. We remind you that this is a non-smoking flight. Smoking is prohibited on the entire aircraft, including the lavatories. Tampering with, disabling, or destroying the lavatory smoke detectors is prohibited by law. Please note that e-cigarettes are not a loophole to this regulation. Should you have any other questions about today's flight, please feel free to ask a flight attendant. Thank you. Gentlemen, please direct your attention to the seatback monitors ahead of you for a video demonstrating the safety features of this aircraft. We recognize some of you may be frequent travelers, but this information is important and we ask for your undivided attention at this time.
Identify this part of the seatbelt by the square hole on one end. with your left hand, pick up the buckle, and then slowly and steadily move the metal end towards the buckle, keeping both ends perfectly aligned. Carefully insert the metal end into the buckle until you hear it click.
To tighten the strap, find the end of the strap and pull. Careful not to pull too tight, or you'll have to loosen it once more.
To release your seatbelt in the event you need to leave your seat, find the top of the buckle. Once you've found the top of the buckle, lift it up and it will release.
Now it's time to get underway to your exciting destination, whether it's sipping wine in Paris or whale watching in Nova Scotia.
Please make sure your seat is all the way up, all electronic devices are shut off and put away, and your tray table is stowed.
Carry-on luggage should be placed all the way under the seat in front of you or in the overhead bin. Please switch your handheld devices to airplane mode now. Please be aware that failure to do so could lead to a potentially catastrophic navigation disaster.
U.S. law strictly prohibits smoking on the airplane at any time. Tampering with, disabling, or destroying smoke detectors in the lavatory may result in a fine.
It's now time to take out and review the safety card, located in the seat back pocket in front of you.
Note the fine craftsmanship, colorful, clear illustrations, and sturdy laminations. Our safety cards are built to last. Use the safety card to find the plane's exits marked by the large arrows and the word exit. There are exits in the front and rear of the plane.
In the event of an evacuation from the cabin, follow the emergency lights to an exit. We ask that you leave all carry-on items behind.
If you feel you must grab something to bring along as you evacuate, we suggest you take a copy of Pan Atlantica's award-winning in-flight magazine, Stratosphere.
It's filled with gorgeous pictures of hotels, sponsored reviews for high-end restaurants, as well as maps of every major airport, and fun games to play, like Sudoku.
Should the airplane cabin lose pressure, do not panic. Oxygen masks will drop automatically. When they do, again, do not panic. The yellow cup fits over your nose and mouth, and the elastic band fits around the back of your head. Normal breathing will start the flow of oxygen. Remember, put your own mask on first before helping others. We promise it's the right thing to do.
Life vests can be found next to, over, or underneath your seat, or in some cases, behind your seat. It depends on the model of the plane you're flying in. Once you are safely outside the airplane, pull on the tab to inflate your vest, or inflate manually using the red tube. There is no need to do both.
Please note that your seat cushion can also be used as a flotation device. How clever! Your cabin crew will now be coming around to do a final cabin check. Everyone here at Pan Atlantica is proud to be part of making your flight today a wonderful experience.
If there's anything at all our cabin crew can do to make your flight more enjoyable, please don't hesitate to ask using the call button.
We hope you have an enjoyable,
entertaining,
relaxing,
or productive flight.
We here at Pan Atlantica salute you, because flying people places is what we do.
G'day, folks. On behalf of myself and the flight crew, it's our distinct pleasure to welcome you on board Pan Atlantica Flight 708 with non-stop service to Halifax. Our flight time today should be around 2 hours, maybe a little over. We'll be cruising at around 35,000 feet off the ground and traveling about 575 miles per hour. I'll be back in touch if we've got any other updates for you en route. For now, sit back, relax, and enjoy the flight. Everyone, we're second in line for departure at the moment. Should have you off the ground in a couple of minutes. Cabin crew, prepare for takeoff.
Hey everyone, before I begin this week's episode, I have some exciting news. We're going to start selling merchandise for Imaginary Worlds. T-shirts, hats, mugs, tote bags, stickers, pillows, laptop sleeves, lots of stuff. Now, we have some designs that we're working on, but first, we wanted to reach out to you for fan art that we could put on all this merch. You could redesign the Imaginary Worlds logo, or create art inspired by your favorite episode. ImaginaryWorldsPodcast.org. We will pick our favorites and announce the winners on social media. I'm very excited to see what you come up with. You're listening to Imaginary Worlds, a show about how we create them and why we suspend our disbelief. I'm Eric Malinsky. There's a scene that I keep thinking about from the end of Interstellar, then spoilers ahead, because I'm going to talk about the ending. Now, the premise of the movie is that in the future, we can't grow food on the Earth anymore, but no one's sure why. So a group of astronauts, led by Matthew McConaughey, blast off, looking for other planets that humans could live on. Eventually, they find some planets. They're okay, not great, and a lot of other dramatic stuff happens. But in the end, Matthew McConaughey returns to our solar system, and he discovers that humanity had actually survived all this time by living on a giant space station. And the physics of the space station were mind-boggling. I mean, it looked like somebody had taken a flat plane of Earth and rolled it up into a tube, so the houses are hanging sideways and upside down. In fact, we see these kids playing baseball, and a pop fly shoots straight up into the skylight of a house hanging upside down.
Where am I?
Cooper Station, currently orbiting Saturn.
And I've always found it fascinating how much some people really want to live on the moon or Mars or in a space station, where just about every natural resource that we take for granted on the Earth has to be recreated from scratch, and it's incredibly fragile. But people are investing a lot of time and money and their imaginations into life in space, and they say we are closer than ever to making that a reality. So I was really wondering, well, what do they imagine? And how much does it reflect science fiction? All right, so going back to that giant curved space cylinder that we saw in Interstellar, that idea originally came from a physics professor at Princeton named Gerard K. O'Neill. 50 years ago, he was working with his students on designing solar-powered satellites. And I know I said that just about every natural resource in Earth is really hard to find in space. That's definitely not true with solar power, because, you know, of course, on the Earth,
night shuts it off instantly, where a cloud runs over and shuts it off instantly.
Robert Smith works for the Space Studies Institute, which was founded by the late Gerard K. O'Neill. Robert says back in the 60s, when O'Neill was figuring out the math for these solar-powered satellites, O'Neill realized these structures didn't have to be limited by space. I mean, they could be as big as cruise ships or cities, which means people could live and work up there. But, and I'd said to Robert Smith, the thing that I don't understand is why O'Neill's cylinders have to curve into themselves like an M.C. Escher painting. And how does it even work? I mean, I barely understand how gravity works on the Earth. Like, I don't quite understand why people standing in Antarctica don't feel like they're standing upside down on the Earth. So I really don't understand how that would work on a man-made structure that's smaller than a planet.
Okay, when you're a kid, you take a bucket, right, and you fill it with water, and you're at the beach, right? You take a bucket, you fill it with water, and you spin your arm around above your head, and the water doesn't come out, right?
I never did that, but I believe you.
You never did that?
No.
What kind of a kid are you?
I was collecting seashells and sea glass.
Well, you get the idea, okay? You'll do it now. Take a coffee cup outside, put water in it, take your arm and just spin it in a circle. Even though it's upside down at a certain point, the water doesn't come out. It's being pushed against the inside of the cup. If you're at the amusement park and they have one of those things that you stand in, it starts to spin, and then they...
everybody. This is your captain speaking. We've hit our cruising altitude of 32,000 feet. So welcome to the flight. Hopefully we'll continue to have smooth weather all the way to the destination. I'll be back in touch if we've got any other updates for you en route.
Ladies and gentlemen, the captain has turned off the fasten seatbelt sign, indicating we've reached our cruising altitude. You are now free to move about the cabin, but we ask that while in your seat, you keep your seatbelt fastened. At this time, the use of all approved portable electronic devices is permitted.
Look, fellas, I'm Rin Tin Tin. Now I got you. You're a dead wabbit.
Telegram for Elmer Fudd.
What's up, Doc?
Dear nephew, I'm waiving you $3 million in my will. Uncle Wooey. Oh, boy, I'm rich. P.S. But you don't get 1 cent if you harm any animals, especially wabbits. You're free now with the wabbit. Go and romp and frolic in the forest. Oh, boy, I'm rich.
Okay, fellas, break it up.
$3 million.
Angel in disguise. Angel in disguise.
Come on out, or I'll blow your head off. Come on out, or I'll blow your head off.
I'm just an angel in disguise.
Hi there. Thank you.
Mr. Wabbit, go on back to the forest where you belong. Be nice with the wabbit.
Ooh, ouch, ouch! Hey, what are you trying to do, kill me? Are you flexing my skull? I'm gonna call Uncle Louie, that's what I'm gonna do. Operator! Hey, you got a nickel? Hello, operator! Give me walnut tree. Oh, that you, Mert? How's every little thing?
Please, Mr. Wabbit, don't call Uncle Wooey. I won't hurt you again. I promise.
Well, okay. But watch your step after this, fat boy. Hey, what do you got to eat around this joint?
Eat? Eat. I'll fix this guy. Fate he'll twig me, huh? Step right this way. That'll fix him.
Why, the dirty double-crossing. Open up! Hey, I'm getting pneumonia! Open up! I'll die! No! I'm too young to die! Please! Please let me in! Hey, this scene ought to get me the Academy Award. Say goodbye to Uncle Louie for me.
Oh. Uncle Louie? What have I done?
In a few moments, flight attendants will be coming around the cabin with our in-flight service. We will be serving a snack.
Trash. Hello. Excuse me. Hello? Excuse me.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are now making our final approach. Please take this time to double-check your seatbelt and ensure it is indeed securely fastened. Flight attendants will be passing around the cabin one final time to make a compliance check and pick up any remaining trash. Thank you. We'll be on the ground shortly.
Thank you.
right. Cap, prepare for landing.
For your safety and comfort, please remain seated with your seatbelt fastened until the captain turns off the fasten seatbelt sign. This will indicate that we have parked at the gate and that it is safe for you to get up. Cellular phones may be used now. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Halifax Stanfield International Airport. Current time, around 7:15. On behalf of myself, and the rest of our hardworking crew, would like to thank you for choosing Pan Atlantic on your trip today. We know you have a choice of carriers, and we appreciate you choosing Pan Atlantic today. We'd love to see you on board again soon. In the meantime, have a wonderful stay.
Thank you.